In this video, we will try to understand how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying point load and uniformly distributed load. As shown over here in the figure, the cantilever beam is carrying the point loads of 3 kN and 5 kN and a UDL of 2 kN per meter for 3 meter length from the fixed end of the cantilever. Now let us start with the shear force diagram. The conventions that we are using for shear force diagram calculations are upward negative and downward positive. Now we have to start from the free end. Shear force at point P is zero because there is no load or force that is acting at point P. Similarly, shear force at the C right of the C, as there is no force that is acting between P and C, we can say that shear force at C right is zero. Shear force exactly at point C, there will be a point load which is acting in the downward direction, and as per our convention, the downward acting loads, they are considered as positive. So therefore we can say that shear force at point C is plus 5 kN. Shear force at D right will be same as that of C because there is no force that is acting between C and D. Shear force exactly at D will be in this 5 kN, there is again downward acting 3 kN load will be added, so it is 5 plus 3, that is 8 kN. And shear force at point A will be this shear force at D plus this UDL of 2 into 3. So this UDL is 2 kN per meter. So for 1 meter length, the UDL is 2. Then for 3 meter length, it will be 2 into 3. So it is 8 plus 6, that is 14 kN. So this is the shear force that is acting at A, and it is also the reaction that is acting in the upward direction at this particular point A. So let us draw using these particular values the shear force diagram. So at B it is 0, at C it is 0. So this is the horizontal line matching with the baseline. Then at point C it is 5 kN, will remain same up to D right. At point D it will be 8 kN, and then it increases to 14 kN as shown over here. So this will complete our shear force diagram. Now let us see how to draw the bending moment diagram. The conventions which we have used for drawing the bending moment diagram are clockwise negative and anticlockwise positive. Now here we have converted this uniformly distributed load into point load, so that is 2 into 3, and it will be acting at the center of 3 meter length, that is 1.5 meter. Now we'll start with our bending moment diagram. Bending moment at the free end is 0 because there are no forces which are acting on the right hand side of B. Bending moment at C is also 0 because there is no force that is acting, no forces that those are acting on the right hand side of C. Now bending moment at D, consider all the forces on the right hand side of D. So there is only one force, that is downward acting this 5 kN load. This 5 multiplied by this 2, that is the perpendicular distance, and it will produce the clockwise moment, and clockwise moment we have considered as negative. So it is minus 5 into 2, that is minus 10 kN meter. Bending moment at point A, you have to consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of this particular B. So on the right hand side of A, the forces which are acting, there are this 5 kN point load, this 3 kN point load, and the UDL which we have converted into the point load. Now this 5 kN load will produce the clockwise moment about A, and the perpendicular distance is 2 plus 3, that is 5. So it is 5 into 5 minus 5 into 5, because it is producing clockwise moment, which we have considered as negative. This 3 kilonewton point load will again produce the clockwise moment. So it is 3 into 3. So that is 9. Then this u.d.l, which we have converted into point load, that will also produce the clockwise moment. So it is 2 into 3, that is the u.d.l, which we have converted into point load, and multiply by perpendicular distance is 1.5 meter. So it is minus 43 kilonewton meter. Using these values, we can draw the bending moment diagram. At B and C, it is 0. Then at D, it is minus 10 kilonewton meter, and at point A, it is minus 43 kilonewton meter. So in this way, we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying point load and uniformly distributed load. Thank you very much for watching.